Abe Lincoln's Dream by Lane Smith. 1943. Falla wouldn't enter that room. 1968. Neither would Yerkes. 1985. Or Rex. Some say they saw the ghost on the 12th of February, but on that day everyone was wearing stovepipe hats, so who could tell? Then one day, a girl wandering from her tour discovered a tall man standing over the Gettysburg Address. "Hi," said Quincy. "Hello, child," he said. He was dressed in black from hat to boot, but she wasn't frightened. He had a long face that made her feel sorry for him. "Are you lost?" she asked. "I don't think so," he said, walking through a wall. "You look confused." "Why, I'm right as rain," he said. "Sure?" "Well, not really. No. Ghosts are no good at telling fibs," he said. "You can see right through them." "That is a very silly joke," she said. He returned with a rose. "Truth is, I'm thinking of a dream I had last night," he said. "It's always the same. I'm on a ship sailing rapidly for some shore I know not where. In my nightmares, I'm in class," she said. "Naked as a jaybird, totally embarrassing." "I wouldn't worry. That's a common dream," he said. "Like the one where bears have gotten into your cabin?" He paced the floor. "You're tall," she said, taking four steps to his one. "Do you know how long a man's legs should be?" he asked. "No." "Long enough to reach the floor." She thought this joke was sillier than the last, but she laughed to be polite. "I apologize if I appear restless, but there was so much to do beyond 1865. Our union was so fragile, so uncertain, like that ship on the rocky sea." She led him to the door. "Oh no, I never leave the executive mansion," he protested. "You should," she said. "A lot has changed since 1865, including the name of the executive mansion. We just call it the White House now." The ghost did the flying. The girl answered the questions. "Are the states united?" he asked. "Did that work out?" "Yes, that worked out fine." "And equality for all?" he asked. "That's working out too," she said. "It's getting better all the time." "And man?" he asked. "Does he no longer fuss and fight with his fellow man?" "We're still working on that one. But I think overall the Founding Fathers would be proud of our progress, don't you?" said Quincy. "Why, I think they would be over the moon." "Over the moon, yes. There's one last thing I want to show you," she said. "My stars," he said, "we have come a long way. Three cheers and bally ho." His tour over, he returned her to hers as he began to disappear one final time. "Knock, knock," she said. "Who's there?" he said. "Orange." "Orange who?" "Orange, you feeling better now?" "That is a very silly joke," he said. That night, Quincy had a dream. She dreamed of a man, a tall man in black, on a boat moving rapidly towards the rising sun. He was smiling.